Well, I was concerned, like, when I looked in the New Times and I was like, damn, they spend this much time talking about my shitty car? That's good. I have no complaints.
My dad left me some words of wisdom sometime when I got out of jail. And my friend Kevin got out too. And me and Kevin were sitting outside my father's house talking. And we're like, yeah, man, fucking jail sucks and this and that, whatever. And my dad comes out and looked at us. And the only thing he said was he looked at us with a real serious face. And he goes, always remember. Never forget. And he just walks away and leaves us hanging like that. And we're like, what? What do you mean? Remember what? Forget what? Oh my God. Why did he do this to us? He just left us hanging.
That was it.
That was it.
But that's what it was.
That was the thing.
Always remember.
Never forget. Like, with such drama, you know?
I know what he meant.
Yeah, I know too, but damn.
Damn.
Out of nowhere.
Well, you did.
Gargling.
That was great, and then on top of that, you have to give an experience.
Well, you know, as long as they do it right. Because there used to be this guy from fucking Fort Myers. I worked at this health food store. He'd come by all the time. No wig, no fucking hair at all. Bad makeup, fucking almost a beard with earrings and high heels. And I was just like, ugh. People were like, dude, what the fuck's your problem, dude? Whatever, that's the way he wants to live his life and shit. I'm like, he puts no fucking effort in that. If he can't put fucking enough effort in that, how the fuck is he gonna live the rest of his life? Like half-assed, his whole fucking life.
I got a good one for you.